We have the incredible privilege this Shabbos to read Parshas Devarim. And in general, Parshas Devarim and Chumash Devarim is so moving because you get to see almost like unscripted Moshe Rabbeinu. And Rabbi Soloveitchik points out that so much of Moshe Rabbeinu's life was scripted. From the beginning, in his first encounter with HaKadosh Baruch Hu by the burning bush, Shana Lecha Me'arag Lecha, take off your shoes. From that moment, HaKadosh Baruch Hu gives Moshe Rabbeinu the script, and Moshe Rabbeinu, as a dedicated soldier, follows the script. And in fact, Moshe Rabbeinu unfortunately gets into trouble when he goes off script, when he's supposed to speak to the rock, but instead he hits the rock. And what's so beautiful about Chumash Devarim is so much of it is Moshe Rabbeinu just speaking from his heart to Klal Yisrael, recognizing that very soon he's going to take leave of his beloved people. And you feel an urgency. Moshe Rabbeinu just wants to talk to them about anything and everything and convey to them all the beautiful ideas and ideals, because he knows he's not going to be with them as they enter the land. He knows that he's not going to be with them in their bright and beautiful and glorious future. And so he has this urgency to impart as much knowledge, as much wisdom, and as much hadracha, guidance for the future, as possible. But in one of those moments, Moshe Rabbeinu also, gives Moser. He also gives rebuke. In fact, Rashi HaKadosh points out that Moshe Rabbeinu waited to give rebuke until close to his death. He followed suit of Yaakov Abinu. Yaakov rebukes his sons for their various misdeeds, but only does so from his deathbed. Rashi explains because there's a concept that you don't want to constantly rebuke people over and over and over for the same thing. So you see that by the great tzaddikim, they would offer their musar, offer their rebuke close to their deathbed. It's important for me to give you the feedback. It's important for me to give you the rebuke, but I don't want it to tarnish our relationship, and I don't want to keep on rebuking you. So Yaakov Avinu does it in Parshas Vayechi, moments before his death, and Moshe Rabbeinu does it in Chumash Devarim. And in one of those moments of rebuke, Moshe Rabbeinu says to Klal Yisrael, this is in Perek Aleph, Pasuk Yud Beis, Eicha Esal Abadi, Tarchachem Umasachem Berivchem. How can I carry on my own Tarchachem, your burdens, your tircha, difficulties, masachem, or I should say, tarchachem really means your difficulties, a tircha, an effort, your difficulties, masachem, your burdens, rivchem, your fights. Moshe Rabbeinu is saying to Klal Yisrael, you are a contentious, quarrelsome people, and it's difficult for me to handle all of this on my own, and as such, I had to go ahead and onboard additional people to help me. And Rashi HaKadosh comments on this, and he says, what is masachem? What does it mean, your burdens? Melamed Shayu Apikarsin tells you that there are members of Klal Yisrael Apikarsin. Now, an Apikoris is a very strong term. An Apikoris is a heretic. An Apikoris is a non-believer. An Apikoris is someone who knows the MS, knows the truth, but actively turns his or her back on it. Says Rashi, so Moshe was saying, Eicha Salavadi. It's not just the pshat that you're difficult, this all once, this one. There were non-believers. There are Apikarsin amongst you. I can deal with the Jewish people. I can deal with those who follow God. But Apikarsin, people who don't even believe, people who reject HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Torah, mitzvahs, what am I supposed to do with this? I can't handle this alone. And Rabbi Nachman of Breslov asks something so fascinating. He says, I don't understand. Why is it that Rashi says that Apikarsus, remember, look at the words. How could I carry on my own? Tarchachem, your difficulties. Masachem, your burdens. Verivchem, your fight. And Rashi says, Masachem, your burdens. That refers to Apikarsus. That refers to heresy. That refers to heretics. People who reject the Kaddish Baruch Hu. Says the Rebbe, what's the pshat? Why is heresy the burden? So he says something amazing. He says, Ki apikorsus hi masa kavit al ha'adam v'sevel kasha. Says because apikorsus, heresy, is a heavy burden to carry. It weighs down the individual. Ve'ilu l'ma'amin yesh mish'enes chazaka mutzaka. As opposed to the believer, the believer doesn't have to schlep around this weight. I think Rabbi Nachman is telling us something absolutely amazing. See, apikarsus is a burden. Apikarsus is a masa. It's not just apikarsus. What the Rebbe is saying is, we all make mistakes. We all make mistakes. The fact that we sin, the fact that we make mistakes, that's not a chiddush. The shaila is, the question becomes, what do you do in the aftermath of sin? So, if we're honest, so often we spend so much time trying to explain away the sin. It wasn't really a sin. It was really something else. It might have looked like a sin, smelled like a sin, resembled a sin, sounded like a sin. It wasn't a sin. I'll tell you why. And we have a whole Torah. We construct a whole Torah to explain why the sin is not the sin. And by the time you finish explaining the Torah, you're schwitzing, you're exhausted. A lot of effort went in to go ahead and explaining why this thing that looks like a sin is not really a sin. When instead, and what ends up happening, so I explain it away, I'm very happy. and the sin is still on my back. It's still on my shoulder. The pekel is still there, and I have to schlep it around. And every single time the thoughts of the sin come up, I have to once again explain, I have to go through the whole Torah. There's Torah Shebichsav, the Torah Shebalpeh, there's a written law, an oral law, all explanations, Rishonim and Achronim, why this is not a sin. And every single time it comes to my mind, I have to explain it again. It's a burden I schlep around. Masha Inkin, as opposed to, if a person commits an aver and says, you know what, I messed up. And I'm going to do tshuva. I'm going to change myself. I'm going to be better. I'm not going to repeat the mistake. I'm going to learn from it. I'm going to grow from it. Suddenly again, I cast the burden off of my shoulders. Says the Rebbe, this is the choice we have to make in life. Every single chait, every single thing we do wrong, which we all do stuff wrong, every moment of failure, every misdeed, it creates a burden. The burden is created when I make a mistake in life. The shaila is, what kind of person are you? Do you want to keep carrying the burden? Do you want to pretend like the mess up doesn't exist? Like the sin didn't exist, that you didn't do something wrong, and explain it away for all time? You could do that, and maybe you could convince other people, maybe you could even convince yourself. But you're schlepping around the burden of that sin, that masa. Whereas if a person is able to engage in a bit of introspective honesty and say, yes, I failed, I messed up, and maybe I messed up really badly, but you know what? I'm going to do better. I'm going to be better. I'm going to grow from this. Then at that moment, I could offload the masa. I could offload the burden. And instead of being in the sin being something that weighs me down and literally bends my shoulders, it could be something that turns into a catalyst for growth and self-actualization. Moshe Rabbeinu was saying to Klal Yisrael, you know what the most difficult part was? You refused to acknowledge your shortcomings. Echa esalavadi, tarchachem umasachem virivchem. That you made mistakes, that's fine. We all make mistakes. Promotion, this is why you choose not to acknowledge them and fix them and instead just schlep them around, explain them away to anyone and to everyone. For the life of me, I can't understand. Dear friends, this is the choice we must make every day. To err is human, as the famous adage goes. To make mistakes is something we all do. But what we do in the aftermath of mistakes determines whether or not you are a liberated person walking with a proper posture, erect, or bent over, huddled under my pekel, under the masa of my mistakes. It's a choice we make. Do we spend our time trying to explain away why nothing that I did was really wrong? Or do we find the courage to take ownership over my mistakes, acknowledge my mistakes, pledge to do better going forward? And if we do that, we can unshoulder the burden and move ourselves forward in life. May HaKadosh Baruch Hu give us each the koach to be able to remove the masa, face our mistakes, acknowledge them, and progress in life's journey. Wishing everyone a wonderful day, a good Erev Shabbos, and a beautiful Shabbos Kodesh.